Today I will show you how to format a hard drive to store specifically media files on it, basically optimize it for media files. We will begin with starting Disk Manager. You can search for Disk Manager or write in disk mgmt.msc. In the Run window, you will get the Run window by holding Windows key and clicking R. Here we have the Disk Manager. Here we can see the current disks connected in the computer. Now, you will of course know that the drive which you format all the data on it will be lost, so you will need to back up any data you want to save on that drive you are formatting. And also, of course, if you have several disks with the same size, you need to make sure it is the drive which you actually want to format. I can see for this example that my disk 0 has a recovery and EFI partitions, and that is my boot drive. And this one is just an active primary partition with storage. It's an entire other disk. This is not my system one. So it makes very easy. I know this is the one. You can also look for, if you know that the drive you are going to format is sized like 500 gigabytes or something, you will see how many gigabytes it is. This is a 250 gigabyte drive, and this is the available space. Right, so what we want to do is we want to delete the volume. Click yes. Wait for the volume to be deleted. Volume is now deleted. We can now click here. If you have several volumes, you will need to delete them all. If you're sure this is the drive you want to remove and you need to remove EFI partition and recovery partition on that, if it was an old system drive, then you can of course also do that, but you will need to watch my other tutorials for that because it's a little special way that's a little bit complex. You can leave them on as well, you know, they're not that big, but I want to keep it clean, so this complete clean slate. Now we right click on it and we will click simple new volume. New simple volume. You'll get this little wizard here. So we'll click next and we're gonna set this to the max. If this would have been an SSD, I would leave about 10 to 15% unallocated, which means we would remove that value from this and, you know, like putting a zero there, and then we would have a bit of unallocated space, and that would keep the lifetime of the SSD longer. When it is about HDD drives, you may format all and use all the space on the drive, and it will still have the nice lifetime. So we will click next. We will now need to assign the following drive letter. So you can select any letter here which is not already taken. We will select V, because why not? And you can choose anyone that's free, which, yeah, you know, it will tell you if it's not free when you go to the next one. And then you will click next. You will need to select a drive letter. Like, if you do not select a drive letter, you will not be able to browse the disk using Windows Explorer. And now we will format this volume, and you can choose between XFAT and NTFS. You will want to select NTFS if this drive will be used by Windows computers only. If you will use it with both Mac computers and Windows computer, you will need to select XFAT. But NTFS is the recommended file system for Windows units. Then we have allocation unit size, and this is the little trick when we are formatting the drive specifically for media. You will want to choose the highest allocation unit size available. This will optimize your drive for larger files. But if you would, example, have a lot of small files on this, like tiny files that are less than 1 megabyte onto your system, then a smaller allocation size would be better, because this will kind of waste some space, but having the highest allocation unit size will make it faster to browse. So maybe a little waste space, but a little faster to use. But when you are installing a system like Windows on a drive, you will want to keep this to default, of course, because otherwise it will not work as intended, but biggest size is great for media storage, like pictures and movies and music. And then you'll need to change the name. You will want to have a little name for the drive. You may use Perform Quick Format. So you can now click Next. You can review the data here and click Finish. And there you get it. The drive is formatted and now available, and you may write some folders, movies or whatever, and start storing them on the drive. Fantastic, formatted and all. I do hope this video helped you, and if it did, please leave a like and also subscribe for weekly tech tutorials. This is your host, Jim Odism, signing out.